All right, this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com with the strawberry update. So for all of you that are regular viewers and have saw when I planted out this strawberry bed, we did a little bit different fertilization or a little bit different things when we planted each row. And I was gonna give you the updates on how things are growing thus far. So we'll go down the line to remind you. This first line here is the control. So this one we basically just added the rock dust and worm castings and compost in the entire bed, and that's all this first row got, and it actually looks pretty good. The next row here, in every hole we did extra rock dust, so the same, it got the same as the control plus one scoop of rock dust per hole. The next bed here, or the next row here, we got extra rock dust plus mycorrhizae. Mycorrhizae is a beneficial fungi. And then the next bed, the next row here, we got a roots hydro Hydroponics mixed in a bottle, some organic hydroponics soil amendment. Then we added bat guano, sea kelp, and alfalfa meal. And then it also has, you know, the rock dust, worm castings, and regular compost that the whole rest of the bed got. And this last bed, we had the Gorilla Grow and the Dino Grow. So if you kind of look at the whole bed like I'm looking in front of it, you know, it looks like the Gorilla Grow and the Dino Grow row, for the most part, there's several plants in them that are doing pretty good, but most of them are not doing so well. And then that's the worst. The next worst is probably the control. And the control line, you know, some of them are small and not doing so well. Probably the next worst is the, I don't know, it's tough to say. Like, these three middle rows are probably like the best. The two outer rows are not doing so well. It's hard to say which one's really doing well the best. I guess we could kind of look on the number of fruits too. So the one with the extra rock dust looks like it actually has the most fruits, followed by the extra rock dust and the mycorrhizae. And then this row here with the roots hydroponic, the back guano, sea kelp, and alfalfa meal, although the plants look pretty lush and vibrant and tall, there's not a whole lot of like fruit action on those. So I definitely have to say, use the rock dust. I mean, the rock dust and the rock dust and mycorrhizae seem to do the best. So that's what I'd recommend. So here's the first picking. I'm gonna go around and pick some of the berries off the first time. I'm gonna see how many little cartons I could fill up. And some of the bugs have been getting my strawberries, and I'm gonna have to get you know, more serious on them. I usually don't like to pick my strawberries until they're absolutely ripe, and that's a problem because then the bugs tend to get them a little bit faster. So today I'm picking them even if and there's like a hole in one of them, but you know, it's still good to eat. These will get blended up into a smoothie for me today. They seem to like the tops there. There's a nice little one there, not quite as ripe as I'd like. But yeah, I mean, each plant pretty much has like each plant pretty much has, in some of the rows, like this first row really doesn't have a whole lot. Many plants have at least one ripe you could pick now. This plant had two. No, that's not ripe. All right, so we picked almost two little containers full of strawberries, and this is the first harvest. It's here now in middle of May, so it, you know, pretty fast. We had some strawberries. It's been about 2 months, I believe, since I planted them. Some of them could be a little bit riper, and most of them have bug holes. So we're gonna do something about the bugs, because another question I get is, John, what do you do about insects? So I usually come out here and smush them as much as I see them. I was pulling these up, and as I pull them up, if I saw any bugs, I'd smush them. And primarily it looked like I had these things called sow bugs. If you don't know what a sow bug is, we can show you the picture on here. Had a lot of sow bugs and also some earwigs. And I haven't seen any snails or slugs in this bed yet. But what we're gonna use for that is we're gonna use this stuff here. This is called Sluggo Plus. And the Sluggo is normally just for the snails and slugs, but this is the Sluggo Plus. It's fairly new, just came out. So this is Sluggo Plus. The original Sluggo is just good for snails and slugs. But the new plus version has spinosad. And the spinosad is basically a naturally occurring soil-dwelling bacterium that interrupts the the sow bugs and earwigs and probably other bugs from actually living. So we're gonna do is we're gonna just basically take this off, take this top off, and we're just gonna shake this on the bed. This is basically naturally or organic control for organic gardening, so it's not harmful to pets. A lot of snail baits and things, if your pet, dog, or cat would eat it, it would get really sick. But this is safe for you use around children and pets. So what I'm gonna do is, and the other thing I want to point out too is, I found that when we were topping these carrots, we had these carrots and I had left some carrots out here at the top sitting there. And over the night, the sow bugs really seem to like the carrots actually more than the strawberries. So we're just gonna leave a couple carrot tops there and see if it attracts some more sow bugs. And if it does, we're just gonna smush them. But in the meantime, we're gonna take some of this Sluggo Plus, and what I'm gonna do is just gently, broadcast this in rows between the plants. And I'm not putting too much in there. And this is what I do for organic pest management. Hopefully this stuff is gonna work. And I guess we'll see next time I harvest.